Hi everybody, welcome back to the 10th of an hour with Griffin Bridgers. For today's episode, episode 26, we're going to explore a spousal rollover of an IRA that is payable to a trust as designated beneficiary instead of to the spouse. And we're going to examine a recent private letter ruling that illustrated the principles that need to be followed in order to make a successful rollover in this type of case. Now, as always, this presentation is not intended to be legal or tax advice, so if you wish to implement any of the strategies in this presentation, please consult with an attorney and or tax advisor. Now, any IRA for which the designated beneficiary is a spouse can be rolled over into an IRA in the spouse's name. And the benefit of that is that if the spouse has a later required beginning date, the spouse doesn't have to start taking required minimum distributions until they now reach age 72, essentially, under the Secure Act. However, if the designated beneficiary is not the spouse, it's treated as an inherited IRA. And the difference is that no rollover is permitted. So no matter how old the designated beneficiary or see-through beneficiary of the inherited IRA might be, required minimum distributions have to start in the year after the IRA owner's death, based on that designated beneficiary's life expectancy, or if there is no life expectancy, based on a five-year payout. Now that's a discussion for another time that would probably span many tenths of an hour, but for the time being, we're going to look at, can we mix the world of spouses and trusts? So if a spouse is the sole beneficiary of a trust, could the spousal rollover be preserved? Now there's a lot at stake here, because if it can't be preserved, then depending on how the trust is set up, then it may be inherited an IRA for which distributions have to be made over the lifetime of the spouse, regardless of age. Or in the worst case, if the trust doesn't meet the see-through trust rules, then the IRA may have to be paid out over a five-year period. However, this question was addressed in a recent private letter ruling, PLR 2020-34002, and this added an additional twist in that the IRA was one half community property with respect to the surviving spouse and one half community property with respect to the deceased spouse. And essentially what happened here is that the one half IRA owned by the deceased spouse was payable to a trust as the designated beneficiary for the sole benefit of the surviving spouse. So some key facts here were that for all intents and purposes, the spouse was the controlling party of this trust. So there are three prongs to this. Spouse was the trustee of the designated beneficiary trust, and the spouse was the sole beneficiary of the designated beneficiary trust. That means that nobody else other than the spouse could get income or principal of that trust during the spouse's life. And above and beyond that, the spouse also had an unrestricted right to withdraw all of the principal and income of the designated beneficiary trust, including the IRA itself. So what the spouse had proposed to do is use this withdrawal right to take the IRA out of the trust and roll the proceeds into a spousal rollover IRA in her name. So if this were to happen, this would allow her to delay RMDs until her own required beginning date at age 72. So what was at stake if this was not a valid spousal rollover? In the best case, you'd have earlier start date for required minimum distributions. And in the worst case, you'd have a five-year rule applying, or all of the proceeds being taxed to the trust or the surviving spouse when the IRA is withdrawn. But what the IRS found here is that the spouse was eligible for the spousal rollover, mainly because while it was unspoken, this unrestricted withdrawal right and all the facts and circumstances really caused the surviving spouse to effectively be the individual for whose benefit the IRA was maintained, even though the trust was the actual beneficiary on paper. Now, this wasn't cited by the IRS, but it's important to note that the unrestricted withdrawal right would have caused this to be a grantor trust with respect to the surviving spouse anyway, under code section 678A1. The benefit of that is that for all intents and purposes, for income tax purposes, the spouse would be treated as the owner of the IRA anyway. And importantly, there's another provision that didn't apply here, Code Section 691, which taxes any income in respect of a decedent. Now, one of the big pitfalls with that code section is that a distribution from an IRA or a distribution of an IRA from a trust to an individual trust beneficiary in some cases can cause the entire IRA balance to become taxable, because that's treated as an acceleration of income in respect of a decedent. So if that were to happen, that would have been catastrophic. That would have been a huge tax hit to the spouse or the trust or both. So it's important to note that, you know, these are facts that apply just in this case, and it gives a framework for how possibly you could preserve a spousal rollover in trust. But if you really want to preserve that, the better technique tends to be just naming the spouse as beneficiary of the IRA. Thanks again for listening to this episode of the 10th of an Hour. As always, if you have questions or topic suggestions, you can email those to me at griffin.bridgers@gmail.com. Thank you for listening, and I look forward to seeing you in the next episode.